everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine for a 2006 Navigator 53 for sale in San Diego, California. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this yacht has to offer. All right, so we're gonna start out the bow, and as you can see, there is a large fortress anchor here. Nice gradual entryway into the hull of the vessel. There is this great flare that comes out that Navigator is quite known for, really keeping the vessel dry in rough sea conditions. Large, tall stainless steel lifelines. We also have boarding entry gates to both starboard and port side as well too. Lots of windows that just flood the salon with natural light. There's also a forward bimini that goes off to the forward section of the arch. And then again, I'm gonna be moving our way back through so you can see just how much livability we have on the fly. Navigators are built in California, and they're really known for the amount of volume that you get with this yacht. So good quality build, lots of volume, and just easy boats to handle. The swim platform is quite nice here. You can see the three custom staples here on the back. There's also a custom swim step entry boarding ladder there as well. Stainless steel grab handles, lots of rod holders throughout, and then also a custom bait tank here. As we move our way into the aft cockpit, you can see just how large this is. Plenty of seating and area to entertain and just relax. There's also these two sliding doors that open up, so you have great access into the salon of the vessel. Off to the starboard side, we have the couch, coffee table, and then we have a nice chair orientated here. There's the television, again, large windows. So we have the speakers overhead here, lots of lighting throughout. Three benches right here at the countertop that has really a nice galley that just is real open and just inviting. This is like right where you want to be. Off to the starboard side, ice maker, bar, storage. We have a freezer, refrigerator here. This is a three burner, a stovetop, a princess electric range. And then as we move our way back, you can see just all of the cabinetry here in the salon itself. This is the second access down to the engine room. We have a double stainless steel sinks. There is a convection sharp microwave oven and lots of storage throughout. But again, you can just picture yourself being here, having a nice open view, being, you know, even here at this beautiful slip that is potentially transferable on Harbor Island or in Catalina, just in enjoying everything and all the moments. Lots of windows, as I mentioned, great visibility in and out. As we move up forward, this is our electrical panel. This is where all of our main breaker switches are, generator start, stop here, and then also obviously lighting and all systems. Additional storage. Moving up, we have access out to the starboard side, up to the bow of the vessel. You do have access to both stern and bow, which is quite nice. But looking at this platform here at the lower pilot house, this is really impressive because of this nice large L-shaped seating here, Corian countertop, you know, built onto a stainless steel pedestal here. Great windows, great visibility. So here at the helm of the vessel, you can just see, look at this. This is phenomenal visibility all the way around, and it really just incorporates this lower salon galley. So you're part of the action with everybody. We have our transmission throttle controls. We also have the Furuno radar, Furuno GPS, ICOM VHF. The hour meters and RPM gauges, temperature gauges are all set here. I believe there's 2030 hours on the engines. I'm going to take you up to the flybridge. And so here we have five, you know, gradual steps taking us up into the flybridge itself, where our second helm station is. What I really like is that this is a double bench seat versus a single bench seat. So you're actually driving the boat, sitting next to somebody. And then you also have a single one off to the starboard side. But look at this space, all of this seating around. I mean, just a great open space for you to entertain and just enjoy this flybridge with. And then off to the back area, they've had custom stainless steel lifelines, you know, installed, so they're higher, so you can actually utilize this space out here. And again, just looking back aft, you can see how cool this is and just how much usable space there truly is on this yacht. Moving up forward on the fiberglass arch, we have our speakers, lights. Above that is our front, our radar. Here at the upper helm station, we have our ICOM VHF, Fruno GPS, transmission, throttle controls, and both instrument clusters for both starboard and port engine. All right, I'm gonna take you back down and let's go check out the bow of the vessel. Again, coming down is quite nice. You have a good perspective of everything. Lots of handholds to grab onto. Moving through this side door, as I mentioned, this is an opening gate, which is quite nice. And then look at this. This is a massive area up here. Again, it looks like at one time there might have been cushions up here for lounging. You have the nice windlass up here with up and down foot switches. And again, these lifelines are pretty high. They hit you, just I would say mid-thigh. So it gives you a nice secure feel when walking around. All right, I'm going to take you back into the vessel. And we are actually gonna go down below and check out the stateroom configuration. So down below here, we have a couple steps. There is a nice large hanging locker closet here. And then we come down to this platform. Now we can go aft to the master or we can work our way up to the guest cabins, which I'm gonna start out first. We have a double bunk bed here off to the port side. So we have storage hanging, storage below this, but a really nice double bunk beds here. There are two opening hatches that make it quite nice. Directly across from us is our head and shower compartment area. So this is a VacuFlush toilet, a really nice Corian countertops, lots of mirrors, cabinetry, lots of mirrors, and even overhead just really maximizes the space, making it feel really large, and a full walk-in shower. So your guests definitely have a nice head here. Now we're going to the VIP stateroom. The VIP stateroom has amazing amount of storage down below, full hanging locker closet here with this mirror, as you can see here, that just kind of opens it up and allows you, to get dressed out, full length mirror. There's storage in all of these cabinets here, and then also a television with a built-in DVD player. But again, you can see just how the carpet is. The carpet's in really good condition. And overall, I mean, the boat shows really nice and it's definitely been, cared for. Coming into the aft master stateroom. Now, this is impressive. So looking at the bed orientation, you have a true queen size bed here. You come down a couple steps, there's storage underneath the bed as well too. You have a really nice open feel. So you can gain access, on both sides of the bed. So you're not climbing over one another. You have great headroom throughout. I would say it's probably about 6'4" on the headroom around here, 6'4", 6'6". But again, great use of space. Behind these two cabinets, we have our washer and our dryer, which is pretty impressive. Again, lots of cabinet space here. It's got a his and hers. And then centrally located here is a television with a DVD player. So great use of space, lots of countertop space up here as well too. Two opening ports here. And then as we move up forward to the master head and shower compartment, same thing, VacuFlush quiet toilet. We have the Corian molded sinks here, lots of mirrors, medicine cabinets, opening port here, lots of mirrors up above. It gives it just really this nice open feel and space. And then you have your walk-in shower. The shower's pretty impressive, just a great use of space here. And again, here, I can always do this for you guys. But again, great shower, lots of room. You have your fixture here and pretty enjoyable. There's another perspective here of the master bed, and then we'll go ahead and walk back up. You see the rope lighting up underneath here, lots of natural light and just lots of light that just kind of flood this area, just giving it a nice open feel.
It was a lot of yacht to cover in a short period of time. I hope you found it to be helpful and informative. I will also have a link to the full photo shoot where you're gonna see over 100 pictures of the vessel, really going through all the details of the engine room and throughout the boat itself. So again, thank you very much for watching this. If you like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. And please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.